Привет, Америка! Ты слушаешь канал Ретро-Аркейд Игры, любимый канал в Минске для ретро-видеоигр. Подписывайтесь на канал, чтобы быть в курсе всех обзоров.
Welcome to Retro Arcade Reviews. My name is John, and in this episode, we will be reviewing the arcade classic, the Astyanax, also known as the Lord of King in Japan. The Astyanax is a side-scrolling platform game that was developed by Aicom and published by Jaleco in 1989. Now, the Astyanax is a pretty obscure game. I mean, the arcade game, that is, and quite possibly for a pretty good reason. You see, when it comes down to arcade games, release date and competition plays a major factor. Vendors would usually get more profitable games for their businesses, and in 1989, in 1990, which was the North American release date, there was some serious competition. So if there was a choice between the Astyanax and, let's say, games like Final Fight or TMNT, the choice would have been pretty clear. However, the Astyanax is not a bad game. It's actually a pretty cool side-scroller. In the Astyanax, there's really no written story in there. If you read the Wikipedia page, it tells you the story, but the links don't really lead to anything credible. And I couldn't find any production notes or even an instruction manual, so it's incredibly difficult to get any background on the game. But here's what I can gather. First, let's start with the name, the Astyanax. The Astyanax in Greek mythology refers to the Trojan prince and Hector's son Scamandrius. The Trojans called him Astyanax, which means Lord of the City. Fearing retribution and re-establishment of a Trojan monarchy, Neoptolemus, the son of Achilles, killed Astyanax by hurling him from the battlements. However, according to medieval legend, he survived the war, established the kingdom of Messina in Sicily, and established the line that led to Charlemagne. But that's just one version. Other versions, he's just killed straight up. Other than a slight similarity in the name from the Japanese title, there's no similarity in plot, arcade or NES. The arcade game, in my opinion, is more in line with modern-day Arthurian legend, with the whole sword and a stone motif establishing the bearer of the sword as the rightful king and protector of the land. Well, in this case, an axe. Which makes the original Japanese title the Lord of King, or as I would say, the Lord of the King, a more suitable title than something like the Astyanax, which is a bit arbitrary. So in this game, I assume you take the role of the Lord of the King, as the title implies, when you pull the magical axe from a rock. You are then tasked to rescue the kingdom from a wizard who seems to be under the control of an alien being, which looks strikingly similar to the aliens in the Ridley Scott movie, Aliens. You must fight hordes of mythical and extraterrestrial enemies to win back the throne and restore peace to the land. At your disposal, you have an axe that can power up to a flame-wielding weapon when you're not swinging it, and you have a magical lightning attack which can be powered up by collecting the arrowhead icons. You and a friend can play simultaneously. The gameplay and controls are pretty solid, and the game is pretty fun and easy to get through. Now, if you own the TurboGrafx-16, you most likely played the game Legendary Axe, and if you didn't and own the TurboGrafx-16, shame on you. Legendary Axe for the TurboGrafx-16 was like the best game for the system, but people who played Legendary Axe and played the Astyanax in the arcades would have noticed some striking similarities. The gameplay and controls were very similar to one another, and there's an explanation for why that is. Tokuhiro Takamori, who was the designer for Legendary Axe, which came out a year prior, was the designer, producer, and the director of the Astyanax. Games like the Astyanax I find to be in the same category as other mythical arcade games like Legendary Wings, Rygar, Karnov, and Athena. Some titles may be more obscure than others, but I find that these games, like myths, really spur on the imagination. They were pretty original, and I was kind of a big fan of them. Jaleco also released an NES version of the game known simply as Astyanax, with its own unique plot. It's basically like a different game altogether. Other than that, I don't know if there were any re-releases for the game, so it's pretty obscure. The only way to possibly play the game is through an emulator, which is cool because the game doesn't feel repetitive. As I said earlier, the game is cool, it's pretty fun, and I say, play the game and let me know what you think.